Welcome to InkThinks. For as long as Smash speculation has been around, I've heard the idea of bonus fighters outside of Smash Bros. DLC coming to the game. The implication is typically, after the second wave of DLC is finished, that we're going to see more and more fighters coming to the game as one-off DLC. And honestly, that's something that I could believe. It seems somewhat reasonable. And it seems like a natural place for a lot of fighters who have fan demand, but maybe not enough fan demand to get into the fighter's pass to enter the game. Recently, however, the director of Smash, Masahiro Sakurai, released on Famitsu column number 629, called On Concluding Work, an update that relates to both his future with the Super Smash Bros. Franchise, as well as the future of Super Smash Bros. DLC in general. As we go through the English translation of this interview, which I found on Twitter, posted by the user @Cephazon, we see Sakurai talk about how he's had a long career in video game development, and how it's really a part of who he is. He also talks about how he knows that, just like everything, his career is eventually going to come to an end, but he wants to work to entertain people as long as he can. He has a real passion for pushing new experiences to people and enriching their lives. He's talked about being done with the Super Smash Bros. Franchise before, so the implication of this isn't super shocking to me, that he's likely going to be done after Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. The question is he right? With Super Smash Bros. Brawl, Sakurai didn't even know the game was going to be developed until it was announced, and then they came to him and asked him to make it. He's been toying with the idea of being done for a while, and so to me this seems like a natural finishing point, his magnum opus where he puts everything that he can into the game. So on the topic of Sakurai's future with Smash, yeah, I kind of believe him this time. I think that this is going to be the end of the Sakurai-led Super Smash Bros. Game. Whether that's going to make the game better, worse, or the same, that's up for you all to decide. My personal opinion is that I could see another director potentially doing better with Super Smash Bros. Than Sakurai, but I don't necessarily trust Nintendo to find that person. Sakurai does a lot of good for Super Smash Bros., and he also does a lot of not great things for it. But the really interesting part comes here at the very last tweet that says, Sakurai says that while we wait, he can say definitively that there are only two fighters remaining. They will both be released this year. Sakurai ends by saying that he will not be quitting game-related work after development wraps up and will continue to work hard to finish. So there we go, this statement is really interesting. We know that we only have two fighters left in this DLC pass, but a lot of people have been speculating about a third pass or potentially circulating rumors about a bonus fighter coming after this game. Waluigi is almost always the pick that I hear for that bonus fighter, and a lot of his fans are the one that repeat this theory, but I've heard it repeated elsewhere as well. So, what does this mean to me? These are the final two characters. If it was anyone but Nintendo, I would have the utmost expectations that these would be the two most hype-filled characters ever. That being said, I don't know how much faith I have in Nintendo to balance the hype of their passes. We saw a really strong middle of the last pass, and then kind of dying off in hype toward the end with Byleth, which I think is a great character, but didn't get a lot of people super excited. So if they are trying to balance hype, I have no idea who they're gonna do that can top Steve and Sephiroth. I wish them the best of luck, and I'm super excited to see who they come up with. I've made several prediction videos on my channel where you can see my personal thoughts on who I think is likely, but if you want to know my genuine prediction, it's that it's going to be someone that almost no one's ever thought of, or at least isn't talked about super widely. Sephiroth, for me, was an example that, yeah, people talked about him, but he wasn't considered super likely en masse, at least by me. And so his inclusion was both something that felt surprising, but also super right. And that's something that I see happening with these last two fighters. But let me know what you think. Do you believe Sakurai here? I've heard a lot of people saying that he's just lying, or he's deflecting for whatever reason, and it's not actually going to be done. I'm inclined to believe him, but I want to know what you think. And if you do believe him, who do you think the final two DLC are going to be? And do you think Nintendo's going to do a good job of balancing the hype throughout the pass? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and until next time, stay smashing.